Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship this day as we gather here today and we get to hear that amazing story again, the birth of our Lord as told to us by our children and our choir. Just a great festive day. And welcome to all of our guests and our visitors, and welcome to those who are joining us online. And again, I invite those online to gather some elements for your communion time. A couple of announcements that we'd like to raise up. Next week, in the morning, it's the fourth Sunday in Advent. In the evening, it's Christmas Eve, okay? So we'll have services at 9:30, our regular time, and then we'll have 4:30 candlelight service. So all you are invited, and you are invited to bring family and friends. Please make sure that you stick around. I think we've got lots of Christmas goodies out there to share, and then we will be putting a few tins together to take to some of those people who are not able to join us here each week. We had a request for those who remember Bob Jessen and Edie, is that the family is petitioning to have the lake that is behind where they lived over here on Turtle River Road, wherever that's at. I know where it's at, but every time I point, people tell me I'm pointing the wrong direction. I don't know which way it is. Anyway, that there's a petition out there asking folks to sign it so that they can submit that request to the state. The lake that's behind their place over there has never had a name, and so they would like to name it in honor of Bob and Edie, called the Jessen Lake. So on the table, there's a petition, and if you'd like to sign that, Bob's family, Bob and Edie's family, would certainly appreciate that. Let us then prepare our hearts for worship. Thank you. We light the Advent wreath as a reminder of the coming and the preparing of the coming of our Lord. The first candle represents faith. The second candle, hope. The third candle that we light, which is the pink one, symbolizes joy and is called the shepherd candle. The shepherds with great joy. The angels announced that Jesus came for humble, unimportant people like them too. In liturgy, the color rose signifies joy. As we wait and get ready, we are thankful that God promises to come and be with us. We light this candle in joy for the promises of God. In Luke chapter 2, do not be afraid, for I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. Let us pray. Faithful God, we are glad for the promises to us. We trust that the time is coming when all people will experience comfort, wholeness, and liberty. May we do our part to bring your good news of great joy to all. Amen. I invite you to stand as you're able as we begin our worship of the order of confession and forgiveness. We begin this day in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole hearts. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. And for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our gathering hymn. Together we pray. Stir up the wills of your faithful people, Lord God, and open our ears to the words of your prophets, that anointed by your Spirit, we may testify to your light through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated and continue with the reading of the word.
Oh. Good morning.
Good morning.
The first reading comes from Isaiah 61, verses 1 through 4 and 8 through 11. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, their offsprings among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom checks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all nations. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And we will read responsibly and Psalms 126, when the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, then we were like those who dream.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad indeed.
Restore our fortunes, O Lord, like the water courses.
Those who sowed with tears will reap with songs of joy.
Those who go out weeping, carrying the seed, will come again with joy, shouldering their sheaves.
Welcome to the Christmas program told by the kids at New Salem. We hope you enjoy the story of Jesus' birth.
A long time ago, a young woman named Mary lived in a village called Nazareth. One day, a beautiful angel appeared to her and said,
"Mary, you are going to have a baby, and you shall name him Jesus."
"I will be happily have the baby, and I will name him Jesus."
Mary married a man named Joseph, who was a carpenter. One day, Joseph had to go to a town called Bethlehem to pay his taxes. Mary went with him on the long, hard journey, even though it was almost time for her to have her baby. When Mary and Joseph arrived in Bethlehem, it was so crowded they had no place to stay.
"What do you want?"
"Can you help us? We traveled a long way and we need a place to stay."
"There is no room here. If you want, you can go with the animals in the stable."
"Come, follow me to the stable."
Joseph carefully led Mary down to the stable. Later that night, she gave birth to a sweet baby boy and named him Jesus. Not too far away, there were shepherds in a field watching over their sheep. During the night, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were afraid. The angel said to the shepherds,
"Please do not be afraid. A baby was born today in Bethlehem. Go and see."
"Star will lead us."
"Let's go to Bethlehem."
The shepherds made their way to Bethlehem to find Mary and Joseph resting in the stable and baby Jesus sleeping peacefully in the manger.
Soon after the shepherds arrived, the wise men came with gifts for baby Jesus.
"I bought presents."
"Do
too far away. The birth of Jesus brought hope to so many people. He grew in wisdom and stature, in the favor of both God and man. He was the Son of God, and sent to save all those who believe in him from their sins.
Thank you. You know that you just told one of the most important stories in all the world? Do you know that? Yeah?
No.
Yeah. Oh, you don't? Well, now you do. Thank you. Thank you for reminding us of this story. Thank you for reminding us of all that happened for baby Jesus to come. It's just absolutely wonderful. And we all thank you many, many times over. Do anybody want to come up and take a picture? Now's the time. And you know what? I want you to go home and watch yourselves on TV. Okay? You were on TV today. Okay? All right. Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay. Thanks for not leaving baby Jesus behind. As the choir sings, you'll notice that there's many times for you as the congregation to join in on some of the great Christmas carols. So thank you. Thank you. In the beginning, there was only God. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit. God spoke, and by the power of God's words, everything was created. The heavens, the earth, the light to shine in the darkness, the skies, the oceans, the land, and all the trees, flowers, fruit, and even grass.
God made the sun to shine by day and the moon to shine by night, and God placed every single star in the skies. Then God created the first man, Adam, and the first woman, Eve. They were created in God's own image, and God blessed them. Then God placed Adam and Eve in a beautiful garden called the Garden of Eden. God said, "You are free to eat from any tree in the garden, but you must not touch the tree of the knowledge of good and evil."
Well, one day, Satan entered that garden disguised as a snake. Adam and Eve listened to that evil serpent, and they disobeyed God. They ate from the one forbidden tree. They chose evil, even when they were surrounded by good. They chose their way over God's ways. And that is called sin.
Sin always has consequences. There is always a price to pay. That price is separation from God. God said to Adam and Eve, "Because you disobeyed me, you must leave this beautiful garden and work for your living."
Well, in the generations that followed, people continued to sin and made bad choices. They forgot about God, but God remained faithful. Well, many years later, the Lord made a promise to Abraham, saying, "If you go where I show you and walk with me, I will bless you. You will be the father of many nations, and from you kings will come. And your descendants will be as numerous as the stars.
I will establish my everlasting covenant with you and your descendants for generations to come. I will be your God and the God of your people. Through you and your seed, all the nations of the earth will be blessed because you have obeyed the voice of God." Abraham believed and followed God.
Thank you. The Lord kept the covenant with Abraham. When Abraham was 100 and Sarah was 90, their son Isaac was born. Isaac and his wife Rebekah had a son named Jacob. Now Jacob, who God also named Israel, was the father of 12 sons: Reuben, Simeon, Levi, Judah, Dan, Naphtali, Gad, Asher, Issachar, Zebulun, Joseph, and Benjamin. Their families grew to be the 12 tribes of Israel. From the tribes of Judah, from the descendants of David, God promised a king. God had also warned Abraham that his descendants would be enslaved and mistreated for 400 years. Still, God promised them hope and salvation. Hundreds of years before Jesus was born, the prophet Micah told of God's coming and kingdom, saying,
"Bethlehem, though you are just a small Judean village, you will be the birthplace of our King. Our Almighty Deliverer is alive and lives forever. In strength and majesty of the Lord God, he will stand and shepherd his flock. His greatness will reach the ends of the world. This one will be our peace."
The prophet Isaiah declared,
"I tell you, a virgin will give birth to a son, and he will be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. And God says, 'This is my chosen one, in whom I will delight.'"
Jeremiah urged the people to repent and turn back to God, saying,
"The time is coming when I will place a righteous branch on King David's throne and send the eternal king. He will be a king who rules with wisdom and justice. His righteousness will prevail throughout the earth, and he will be called Lord."
The triumphant entry of Jesus riding into Jerusalem was predicted by the prophet Zechariah more than 500 years before the prophecy was fulfilled.
"Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout for joy, all Jerusalem. Your king is coming. He is patient and just. He is victorious and will make all things right. He comes humbly, riding the donkey, even a colt, the foal of a donkey. Rejoice, the king shall come."
Thank you. Arise, children of God, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is upon you. Come and see. The people walking in darkness will see a great light. For those living in the land of darkness, the light will shine upon them.
Darkness may cover the earth, but the light of God shines on you. For a child will be born to us. A son will be given to us, and the government will rest on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
Many expected the Prince of Peace to be an earthly king. They wanted a strong leader who would come to rescue them from oppression and free them from the slavery of men. But God's plan promised freedom from the slavery of sin. People thought that what they needed was peace on earth, but God knew what they really needed was peace in their hearts and souls.
How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who announce salvation, and say to Zion, your God reigns.
Spread the word of salvation and peace to the ends of the earth. Lift up your voices and shout for joy, for the Lord has comforted the people. Come, Messiah, come.
Sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to visit a humble young woman named Mary. She was pledged to marry a man named Joseph, a carpenter and a descendant of King David. The angel greeted Mary, saying,
"Rejoice, Mary. You are God's highly favored one. The Lord is with you, and you are truly blessed."
Mary was very startled and confused by what the angel said. She wondered what this great greeting might mean. The angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for God has chosen to bless you greatly. You will be with child and give birth to a son. You are to give him the name Jesus, which means Savior. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his ancestor, King David. He will reign over the house and lineage of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end."
Mary asked the angel,
"But how can this happen, since I have no husband?"
"God will work it out. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. This pure and holy child will be called the Son of God.
Then Mary said, I am the Lord's servant. I am willing to do whatever God wants. May your word to me be fulfilled.
The angel disappeared. An angel also appeared to Joseph in a dream. The angel said to Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for this is God's will. She will have a son, and you will call him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So Joseph did as the angel told him.
A decree was issued from Caesar Augustus, the Roman emperor, that a census should be taken of all the world. Every Roman citizen was required to return to the village of their ancestors in order to register and pay their taxes. Because Joseph was a descendant of King David, he and Mary, who was expecting a child, made the 70-mile journey to Nazareth in Galilee, to the Judean village of Bethlehem. And while they were there, Mary gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for him in the inn.
Shepherds were out in the fields near Bethlehem, watching over their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared before them. The sky lit up as the glory of the Lord shone around them. The shepherds were terrified, but the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that is meant for people everywhere. Today in the city of David, your Savior, the Messiah, has been born. He is Christ the Lord. And this is how you will know him. You will find a baby wrapped in soft clothes and lying in a manger."
And suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to all those on whom God's favor rests. Now when the angels had left them and gone back into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Well, let's go even unto Bethlehem and find the baby that the angel of the God has told us about." So they hurried off, and they found Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus, who was lying in a manger. When the shepherd had seen the Christ child, they ran to tell everyone what happened. And all who heard their story marveled at what the shepherds had said. But Mary kept treasured all of these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, just as the angel told them.
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, wise men from the east arrived unexpectedly in Jerusalem and said,
"Where is the one who has been born king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him."
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world."
No one in Jerusalem could show them the way, so the wise men continued their journey, and the star appeared again.
"There it is again, the star we saw in the east. The star is leading us to Bethlehem, leading us to the promised one. Look, the star has stopped and is shining down on that place. This must be the right place."
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world."
"I praise you, Emmanuel. God is truly with us. I love you, Jesus. You are God's son sent to save us. I bow down and worship you, my Messiah."
Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life."
Why did God put you and me here? So we can be the star of Bethlehem, guiding others to God's love.
May my light shine like the star of Bethlehem. May the world see God's love through me. May my light shine for Jesus, my King.
My Jesus and my King, may I shine so long.
Thank you, choir. Thank you, Annalise and Cheryl, for getting us where we are today. I invite you to stand as you're able as we continue with the prayers of God's people. Fill our mouths with laughter and our tongues with shouts of joy as we bear witness to the great things you have done. Give your church a spirit of gladness as we gather and as we share and as we seek. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You love justice and promise your favor to those who are oppressed, brokenhearted, and incarcerated. Grant wisdom and compassion to those who work for public safety and all who work within prisons and jails and courts, that mercy may increase and violence wither away. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us strength, we pray, for our world without ceasing, and provoke us towards love and good deeds for all who are sick or in need of your guidance and for those who are dying. I invite you then to cup your hands as we symbolize God holding us in his hands. As we lift up to you, Emmy and Jillian, Phyllis and Jackie, Kelly, Megan, Angie, Sally, Gary, Ethan, Jennifer, Brianna, Lacey, Todd, Eric, Gail, Monica, Fritzy, Carolyn, Eddie, Anna, Joan, Glenn, Kira, John, Laura, and those, Lord, we name in our hearts. And for all caregivers and all who grieve, provide for all without adequate housing, food, employment, or access to health care. Empower us as helpers and advocates. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Hear the prayers now, Lord, we offer to you both spoken and silently. It is in faith, O Lord, that we lift the prayers that are gathered in this jar. We give you thanks for the many that have been answered. We give you thanks for those that we wait upon. Grant us patience. Grant us courage. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For into your hands, O gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And now may the peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
And share that peace with one another. And greet those online. Continue now with our tithes and our offerings. Together we pray.
God of abundance,
we bring before you the precious fruits of your creation, and with them our very lives. Teach us patience and hope as we care for those in need, until the coming of your Son, our Savior and Lord. Amen. I invite those joining us online to hold those elements that you have chosen. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in the remembrance of me." And together we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. This is the meal of Christ for the people of Christ. You are invited. You may be seated. Hayden, please come help.
Oh,
I invite you to stand as you are able. And now may the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Together we pray. God, for whom we wait, in this meal you give us a foretaste of that day when the hungry will be fed. Send us forth to make known your deeds and to proclaim the greatness of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And again, all are invited for Christmas goodies and coffee and juice or whatever. I invite you then to receive God's blessing. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our sending hymn. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.